problems. How we serve the health needs of our soldiers returning from war is our unfinished story tonight. Again, there are more questions than answers tonight about the exact nature of Specialist Ivan Lopez's mental health issues. The shooting has reopened questions about how well the military supports the mental health of its troops. For many, the first thing they thought when they heard about yesterday's shooting at Fort Hood was, not again. The 2009 mass shooting by Major Nidal Hassan is still a fresh memory to those who lived through it. 13 people died, 32 were wounded. Another instance of a soldier turning on his fellow soldiers, Hassan was tried, convicted, and is awaiting execution. A chilling fact that we've just learned, Lopez and Hassan bought the guns that they used in their killing sprees at the same gun store, Guns Galore, near Killeen, Texas. That's according to U.S. law enforcement officials. My next guest was one of Hassan's victims. Former Army Staff Sergeant Alonzo Lunsford is joining me now. Mr. Lunsford, you just heard me make reference to the death sentence that Hassan was given. Is that ever going to get carried out?
I personally don't think that they're going to put him to death. No, I don't think it's going to be carried out.
And why not? And do you think he should be put to death?
Well, it's not going to be carried out because he's a paraplegic, one. Two is because if you look at the time span that has occurred with the trial and how things are being done right now, Hassan is an embarrassment to our military. He's an embarrassment to our country. And throughout the whole course of the trial, a lot of times he was treated as if he was a victim and we were just not even a factor. And that's one of the things that I'm very, very upset about. But the good thing about this is that at this point, at the end of the day, I get to go home and lay down in my home beside my wife and hug my children. He gets to hug a cold cot. He would never see the light of day. He would never even feel the warmth of a woman's body. And he would live the rest of his days knowing that he is a failure in his act of jihad, or whatever you want to call it.
Mr. Lunsford, you were shot 7 times, and yet I understand that perhaps the most permanent of your injuries is actually the PTSD from which you suffer. How does that impact your life on a day-to-day basis?
Well, it does have an altering factor in my ADL, my active daily living. But because of my upbringing and my training, is that I'm not going to sit here and cry over what was taken away from me on the 5th of November, 2009. I celebrate what I'm still able to do. Along with the PTSD and the blindness of my left eye, that's part of the nature of the injuries that I sustained that day. But there are programs out there that the Army and other civilian factors have in place to help the service member to deal with PTSD and other factors coming from combat or combative situations that involves trauma.
When you first heard the news yesterday, what ran through your mind?
Anger, disbelief, and just wonder. You know, it's been basically 5 years since our shooting occurred, and here it is, the same base, and looking at the time, the amount of people that were killed or the amount of fatalities, and you have to wonder, 5 years later, have we learned anything from the shooting incident that happened with us? What progress has been made? Now, there has been some that's been made. Is there room for more? Yes, it is. But it then puts you in the mind that after our shooting, everyone or a lot of factors were saying, well, we need to do this, we need to do that. Well, a lot of those things has not been done to this point.